Everything is beautiful. Jay Moore, a beautiful day today.
Everything is beautiful today, Mr. Pat Porter.
How you doing?
Happy Saturday to you.
Yeah, Saturday. We're back at it again. We're live on the radio here.
Yes, thank you.
4680Q.ca or 4680Q.com.
That's right. It's what everybody's been waiting for. Yeah. Everybody all week. You know, has been waiting for the infamous Jay Moore Show with Pat Porter at 3 p.m. And that's what we got going on today. Nothing planned. Sorry to look for the audience. Yeah. Absolutely nothing planned except for some real good music today and some information.
We're talking about Christmas.
And
shopping.
And, of course, happy birthday to Sonny Del Rio.
Oh, that's tomorrow. Yes. That's right. Sonny Del Rio.
Yes.
80th birthday. Sonny's been talking about his 80th birthday for the last couple of years, you know, coming
that's
up.
That's right. We don't know if he's actually 80 or is he maybe 84.
Well, we'll see. Next year, he'll pull it again and say, now I'm 90. Another party.
80 is a good round number to have a party, yeah.
Yeah.
So tomorrow that's happening at the Leander Boat Club in Hamilton, Pat Porter. Yeah. And it's going to be a great, great time. Tommy Gunn, his son.
Tommy, yeah. Tommy's going to be the host of it, but Tommy has consented to let us help out.
That's right.
So
that'll be good. We could take a back seat and let Tommy flex his guns, if you will. There you go.
Tommy Gunn, yeah, and Sonny Del Rio, and the guy they call Q, Rob Plasko, is going to be there. He's the guy that puts this all together every year.
And nobody knows why his name is Q.
I tried to figure that out, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, people that have been calling him Q for 20 years don't even know why he's called Q.
Hmm.
Rob Plasko.
Right.
I mean, he's got hair.
Yeah.
So it's not cue ball.
Is it like he's a pool player?
I don't know. I'm going to have to ask him tomorrow.
That's right.
We'll get him on stage and we'll say, why do they call you that?
Yeah.
You know, he'll give us a funny look and walk away.
Now, if his last name was Q and his first name could be 4680.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's only $10 to get in tomorrow.
Right.
That's it. We should tell people what time it is. 7 till 10 o'clock tomorrow.
Yeah. It's going to be a good time because every time we go to the Leander Boat Club, Pat Porter, it's loaded. People love the blues music, and that's exactly what you're going to see tomorrow. Sonny Del Rio, a big, big star down there, and people will be happy to see him. I'll be happy to see him. And it's going to be a good time because every time we go to the Leander Boat Club, it never fails. We always leave having a great time. And Q, as you call him, really knows how to put on a hell of a good show.
Oh, he does. Yeah. So the guy that I talked to yesterday on my show, Ray Materick.
Yes.
Who had a big hit back in the 70s.
Yeah, Light Linda My Fire.
No.
From the Doors.
not Ray Manzarek.
Yeah.
Ray Materick.
Okay.
Yeah, Linda Put the Coffee On.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You played it yesterday. That could be heard on the archives.
Great song.
Yeah. The Pat Porter Show.
So Ray comes flying in from Vancouver Island, where he lives, you know, the good life.
He's
been retired out there, living on royalties from this song for the last, 40 years or more?
Mm-hmm.
50 years? Yeah. Been a while.
Yeah, he's made some money with it.
Yeah, he's still making money on that. Still
sure
coming.
Is.
He goes to the mailbox and there's more money for him.
Gets a royalty check, gets whatever he needs. He's paid. He's good.
Oh, he's good.
He's good.
He said, I'm a happy guy. I was talking to him yesterday. Well, sure he is, of course. But he's going to be on stage with the original band, his original band from back in the day. And so they're going to be up there to play. And then Tuesday, he's going to be playing a special show at the Westdale Theater.
You
probably saw that place in Westdale. It's an old-time movie theater.
Okay, no, I heard you talking about yesterday on your show. I'm not familiar that well with Hamilton.
Kind of like the Seneca Theater in Niagara Falls, movie theater.
I love that theater.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's fixed up now with the inside's been redone. And Ray Materick band is going to be in there playing.
Beautiful.
On Tuesday night.
Yeah.
So you can check that out as well. There's another plug for Ray Materick.
Yeah.
Good buddy, Ray Materick.
Good buddy, good guest. He puts on a great show, and tomorrow's going to be a great show at the Leander Boat Club, Pat Porter.
7 o'clock tomorrow night. Be down there for sure. The Trick Bag is going to be there. All kinds of special guests. A big birthday party for Sonny Del Rio.
Yeah.
We're going to have a birthday cake.
Oh, yeah. We're going to tear that Leander Boat Club apart because we're not letting Sonny Del Rio's 80th birthday party just be some sort of bust. You know, when it comes to Sonny Del Rio, the people of Hamilton love Sonny Del Rio. And, hey, it could be the end of the Leander Boat Club.
Sonny was there. You know, sometimes I wonder if he's really 80, because I think Sonny was there when the settlers, you know, pioneered Hamilton. And he was the first one to arrive on a covered wagon.
I think.
Set up shop there.
I think Sonny Del Rio, I think Hamilton is his. I think he discovered it. It's his town. The blood runs through his veins, the hammer, and everybody loves Sonny, man. I'm looking forward to it. I just can't get it out of my mind. That's going to be great.
Be fun, yeah.
Yes.
So we're going to get down there about 6:30, and greet some people at the door, you know. And
yes, that's going to be fun. But tonight we got some events too, Pat Porter. First of all, for the wrestling fans out there, Survivor Series is tonight, the big pay-per-view. People wondering if CM Punk is going to make his big return. We'll find that out tonight, so check that out.
Pay-per-view?
Yeah, WWE.
Okay, so how can people access that?
Online? I don't know. I won't be watching it because I was invited to the Bush Show tonight.
Yeah, I know.
Gavin Rosdale invited myself and a friend of yours, Classic Chris.
Oh, yeah.
From old school Border Town Wrestling.
He's the guy that gave me the hashtag Pat Porter Show.
There you go. The one Classic that invented Chris. It. Yeah. So we've been called into this, and I try to get him on the show, Gavin Rosdale, but he... Because the show is sponsored by Y108, he had to stick to Y108. Can you believe that?
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's it. Y108 used to be FM 108 back in the day.
Okay.
They used to play oldies back in the 80s.
Y108 did.
Y108 used to be FM 108.
Oh.
And Hamilton had some old established radio stations like CKOC.
Yeah.
You know, 50,000 watts back in the day. And
yeah.
Excuse me one second. You keep talking while I clear my throat.
Let him clear his throat. I don't really remember that song, Pat Porter. Yes.
It's all clear, yeah.
That's okay.
So back, back in the 70s, CKOC was a huge station for Top 40, kind of like Chum AM or Chum FM in Toronto. In fact, even bigger at the time.
Really?
Yeah, they had all kinds of great stars on there. And then CHML, 900 CHML, also was a powerhouse back in the 60s, 70s. So they had Norm Marshall. They had Paul Hanover. They had all kinds of great stars. They had me back then.
There you go, Pat Porter.
Yeah.
Well, it's interesting when you think of Hamilton. It is a hotbed for, the CFL stars. Angelo Mosca came out of there. The radio.
He used to come in the radio station all the time.
Exactly, yes. Angelo Mosca coming into the radio station. That's exactly what he would be, Mr. Media. Kind of like a Jim Diodati down here, where you just see him everywhere, you know.
Well, you saw him walking in the door, and you just had to pull up a chair and say, "Sit down, Angelo. Let's talk about what do you want to talk about? Anything you want to talk about?" And it went over well. So anyhow, there were these two big powerhouse radio stations in Hamilton, and all of a sudden, this little upstart comes in, FM 108. And they had low power, but it was FM.
Okay.
And they were playing oldies, 50s, and 60s music.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. So,
all kinds of old stuff. They found a guy named Rockin' Robin.
Rockin' Robin.
Rockin' Robin.
Yes, I hired Rockin' Robin once for a DJ gig.
That's right.
For one of the wrestling shows here in Niagara Falls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he was all excited all the time. He had this high-pitched voice. Hey, it's Rockin' Robin, boys and girls. We're going to rock and roll here today all day. I want to hear your calls. Give me a call. We'll play your song for you. So anyhow, the ratings of his show skyrocketed.
Really?
Yeah.
That's the trick.
He had something going.
Yeah, he had something going.
And my management at CHML was getting terrified. They were saying, what's going on here? This guy's stealing our audience, and he sounds like Mickey Mouse.
Right.
But, he'd be playing songs, and he'd make stupid jokes all the time, and then the next day he'd tell the same joke again, Like, you got nothing new, He played the same, Roy Orbison, here's Roy Orbison, here's the Beatles, here's Dave Clark Five,
Yeah.
A Rockin' Robin show. But they, they had a huge audience. Another big radio company called Chorus. Like Bell Media,
Of course.
Kind of thing.
Yeah,
they bought the station and they said we're not going to play this old stuff anymore. We're going to change this into hip hop, and so they called it Energy 108.
Then. Energy. I was trying to think of the name of it. Energy 108. Yes.
You probably remember listening to that one.
That's Energy 108. That was when I was first discovered Y108.
Right.
Well, which was Energy 108.
And so they went into the Toronto market and they stole all the Toronto audience. Because there was no more hip-hop station.
It was like a niche thing for them.
So these guys that managed this independent radio station out of Burlington, it was in a little tiny building that was off of Appleby Road, Appleby Line. Somewhere up there. Building's gone now, but...
Yeah.
Anyway, they were stealing everybody's audience, so the powers that be had to shut them down somehow.
You're kidding.
So, they didn't know what to do about these guys,
Oh.
So they bought the station, and then they changed it from Energy 108 to whatever it is now, Y108.
Y108. Yeah, good question.
Went to Chorus and became... It actually became part of the stable of CHML stations.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they didn't have to worry about competing. They owned it.
Well, that's an interesting interesting history of Hamilton Radio that I didn't know, and I'm sure the audience didn't know. And I appreciate that of you, Pat. But what's great about it is I don't think even the employees at this stage of the game even know that history that worked there.
Maybe not.
You know?
Yeah, because they tried to put a lid on everything to keep it quiet. Because the audience was still there, and they were wondering, what happened to our 50s and 60s music? Where's that? It's gone. Where's Rockin' Robin?
Yeah.
Well,
just for the record, Rockin' Robin may have been great in the day, but the show that I hired him for...
Yeah.
And I met him at a Tim Hortons in around where you live. I won't mention where you live, but... and he talked my ear off for an hour. I heard about that Hamilton radio station. I didn't know anything about radio back in the day, so it was just kind of like I was listening and going, okay, let's get to the point. I just wanted to DJ for a couple of... And then when he got to the venue, Primo Scordino could back this up. He completely didn't have his equipment working, and then when he was playing music, it was that 50s, 60s music at a wrestling show, and it just wasn't the same vibe, you know?
No. I think he was bringing records in, old records, you know, cardboard box.
That's what he had,
Yeah, and it's skipping everything, you know?
Yeah, he filled his trunk with records that would skip and everything, and it was just kind of weird to hear Kiss play Beth with a wrestling crowd trying to get an energetic wrestling show going, and you're... Beth, I hear you calling, and I can't come home. And the crowd just booed him out of the building. And that was the last time I seen Rockin' Robin. I don't know if you're still alive, Rockin' Robin.
I got a further story about that.
All right.
If you got patience to put up with me telling another story.
I love the old radio stories.
So anyhow, when it all disappeared as far as FM 108, I got an offer to come to a satellite company.
Okay.
I'd spent 10 years at CHML, and they made me an offer that was pretty good. So I moved to Niagara, and I was the first voice on satellite radio in Canada ever.
Wow.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I had a show on the Music Radio Network. I had 61 stations that covered my show.
Wow.
And this was generally in the evening or, overnight. But it went right across the country, all the different time zones. And so I did this, and it was a lot of fun. I'd put people on the air, and I'd take phone calls. I had a lot of fun with it. I pretty well had freedom to do whatever I wanted.
Yes.
And then I started getting calls at night from people that would say, "I hate you."
You're kidding.
No, like 3 o'clock in the morning, how do I get this call? "We're going to get you, Porter. We're going to get you."
Oh, it's the other DJs calling.
Yeah. Because all the all-night announcers that picked up the feed of the Music Radio Network getting my show across the country lost their jobs.
Yeah.
So wow. When I left the building, I had to look both ways before I got in my car. But, so then all of a sudden they hired Rockin' Robin.
Yeah.
So he comes over. So he followed me. I did 5 hours, and he came on at 4 o'clock in the morning, which, in Newfoundland is like 5:30 in the morning or whatever time it was.
Okay.
But he came on right after me, and I had to be unhumble, I had a pretty good audience. And then he came on, "Hey, it's Rockin' Robin here, Rockin' Robin here." And then the call started coming, "Where's Pat Porter? Who are you?" because if it was a different part of the country, they weren't familiar with Rockin' Robin from Burlington. Who are you? And then I got a guy that would do voices, funny voices, eh? And he did Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Okay.
And he... Rockin' Robin is a girly man. He's a girly man. So I interviewed him when I knew that Rockin' Robin was on his way to the radio station because he would listen.
Yeah.
And I got this guy that was doing Arnold Schwarzenegger. It was pretty good. I say, "Rockin' Robin's coming up. Girly man. I can't do the voice," but it was funny.
Oh, that's great.
And then, about a half an hour later, Rockin' Robin comes in, walks into the studio, looks at me. "Hey, Robin, how you doing?"
Yeah.
I heard that.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what are you going to do about
that's it?
Yeah. Hey, I love the, it's interesting. I know we're stretching this out, but I don't care because I love the old radio stories. But it's interesting that all this stuff, all this history of the radio, there's not really a lot out there as far as nobody's published anything. There's not, you know what I mean? Like, they're the stories that
you can't tell
head.
These stories.
You can't tell these stories.
Yeah.
And it's just weird the way that we've had such a strong industry for radio here over decades. And it's kind of, in my opinion, a little bit gone now, or at least different. And, yeah, all that history is just memories. Like, nobody has really put the...
so many stories, eh?
So many stories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, maybe I'll write a book.
I think you should write a book, Pat Porter, because you got great stories. I think you should contact that guy that wrote Promo Man, your buddy.
Oh, yeah, Bob Klanik,
And Bob Klanik. And don't forget, I could use a book, too. So put you
in
there.
Of course you'll be in the book. Of course, definitely.
No, I think I need a book. You need a book. We both need separate
books. One more quick story, and then we'll play some music. How's that sound?
That sounds great.
Yeah, so I can shut up, you know.
No, that's fine. I got a quick one, too. We're going into music, but you go ahead.
All right. So I worked at a radio station, a major market station, and I won't tell you what it is because of the story that's going to follow here.
Right.
But I was doing 7 till midnight at that station, Monday to Friday.
Yeah.
And then there was a guy that came in after me. We'll call him Dave.
Okay.
Dave did the all-night show.
Okay.
There was a fire escape outside the building that went right down to the main floor.
Okay.
And so if people could walk up the fire escape, they could bang on this door, and you could walk over and who's there, you know, and you let them in.
Yeah.
If you want. So he had all these hookers brought in. The taxi cab had dropped them off at... 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
They'd bang on the fire escape door and he'd let him in. So he figured he'd never get caught because the bosses were all asleep and everything. Eh?
Right, yeah.
Anyway, he gets all these hookers dropped off by taxi. And he's playing songs and they're dancing around. They're dancing around the studio. Anyway, he lost track of time. 4 o'clock in the morning, the boss comes in.
Nice.
Yeah, the boss walks into the studio and, whoa, I forgot, you know, these guys should have been gone by now. There's three hookers in there.
Oh, that's tremendous.
Yeah. Anyway, that was the last we saw of Dave.
Yeah, Dave. Yeah. What happened to Dave? Banged into the heater.
He didn't show up the next night. He just disappeared.
That's great. Yeah, that's when you know you're fired. But those are the good old days of radio, and I'm sure in the major markets, they all have those overnight stories of something going on at the radio station.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorites that I'm going to kind of risk. I maybe shouldn't say it, but I'm going to risk it because it's so funny to me.
Yeah.
But Y108 when they were doing their rock music and they were competing with the big station here in St. Catharines and the former broadcaster, the initials, I'll just say the initials, you know who I'm talking about, was working at that major market and she used to call Y108 and whoever was on the air would answer from Y108 and she would put on air at the major market at the major station here in St. Catharines. They would answer Y108 and she would go, "Good question." And it was one of my favorite bits. And shout outs wherever you are.
Oh, pretty
funny.
It was
one of my favorites. Y108. Good question.
Good question.
from the competing radio station.
Oh, boy.
I don't know if any of that made sense, but it was just
it did.
Okay.
It made sense. It was funny, and you can't get away with much of that anymore. You know?
No, you can't get away with that.
No, they tell you what music to play. They say, okay, time to read the weather. You got 20 seconds.
Yeah.
Get the weather in there.
Yeah.
And then we're going to play 18,000 commercials.
Yeah.
We're going to be back with 7 songs in a row that you've heard like 10,000 times already.
That's right, and that's why, Pat Porter, you said goodbye, terrestrial radio.
That's it.
And hello, online radio.
You got it.
And we love our home here at 4680Q.
You got it. All right. All right. Infamous Jay Moore Show. It's your show here today. I got a song that you picked out.
All right, roll her up, Pat Porter.
Okay, this is Rob Zombie. Here's
and by roll her up, I mean, let's go smoke one.
Take me to the home, take boots and ultra lamps in heaven.
right, there we go, Infamous J. Moore. Yeah. What's
four,
that?
Six, Rob Zombie here on 4680Q.
Yeah.
And, you know, just one of those days, Pat Porter.
Well, maybe we'll play Tony Orlando in a while.
I don't want to sweat too hard today. We're just having a chill day here at the radio station. Yeah.
We got to talk about our partners and sponsors here at 4680Q.
All right.
You know, who do we start with? Let's start with the Regency.
All right.
Regency Athletic Resort. And I was up there on Wednesday. I stopped in to have lunch and met with Esther and Sean Duff, who looks after the grounds outside.
Yes.
Baseball, yes. You know, baseball, the volleyball, the yes. big outdoor stages, all that stuff.
Great worker, Sean Duff.
Oh, yeah. So I had some of their great food and, you know, just enjoyed sitting around looking at what they've done on the inside as well.
Okay.
And they've got blues now on Thursday evenings with the Thomas Nelson Band. That's going over very well.
Absolutely.
And then Saturday afternoon, they've got Steve Grisbrook Blues, etc.
And that's happening right now, in fact.
Yeah.
And if so you just give me a second, I'm a little bit unprepared, but I do have the special guest on for this afternoon.
Okay.
Listed here. David Johansson.
Yeah.
Yeah, David Johansson, and they're even recommending to make a reservation now because it's been filling up in the afternoons. Yeah. People love the blues. They've always loved the blues at the Regency.
We popped up there about a month ago on a Saturday afternoon, and it was pretty well getting full in the afternoon yet, and then they were dancing as well because they made a big space for a dance floor now.
Yeah.
So they were dancing and looking around. All the young women were giving you the eye, you know.
Yeah.
They say, that's Jay Morrow.
Yeah, they did. I know. Infamous Jay Morrow. I have my little booth. I've already got it picked out in the corner. Esther reserves it for me. But yeah, Steve Grisbrook down there with blues, etc. And David Johansson happening right now, Pat Porter. Yeah.
You know what happens on Friday nights from 7 o'clock? Karaoke.
Friday with karaoke, yes, absolutely.
With Steve-O and the Vikings.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's Mountain Road, Niagara Falls, right off the QEW. Just take the top of right top of the hill there. Take the exit.
Right there. Right there. You can see it right in front of your face as soon as you get off if you're coming, 40 rebound. I don't know the other way.
Doesn't matter. Wherever you are, take the Mountain Road exit.
Everybody knows the Regency, let's face it.
Yeah, for sure.
Who are we kidding? Who are we kidding?
We can't wait to get back there in the springtime and the summertime and get up on the outdoor stage. Another one, Herndon Estate Winery. Another one of our sponsors.
Okay.
Are you looking at videos on your phone?
No. Okay. No. Listen, before you go to Herndon's, I'll tell you what I'm looking at my phone because this is very important. People have texted me about Christmas already. You know, you got to be part of these Secret Santas and everything else.
Yeah.
This is what I want everybody to buy me, Pat Porter, before you move to
Herndon's. To buy you, yeah?
Yeah. This year, the Merry Millions have just come out. The OLG Realtor. Can I say that?
Yeah.
500,000 tickets are available from November 21st to January 9th at any OLG Realtor location. And this is featuring guaranteed prizes up to $1 million. It's the Merry Millions, Pat Porter. And this is what I want you to buy me for Christmas.
You want a lottery ticket.
It's $20 per ticket, and I want money more than anything.
Why not just give you the $20? You know you at least got something.
But what's great about the lottery... Oh, shut up. What's great about the lottery is it's only available in Ontario, so it's not spread out all over the place. So someone in Ontario is going to win some major, major money.
Do you think it's going to be you?
Three $1 million main draw prizes, $50,000 early bird prizes, 400 plus prizes between $1,000 and $250,000. All winning numbers will be drawn from quick picks sold. So that's what I want, Pat Porter.
How about your Vegas ticket at the variety store? You could scratch that.
You bought me absolutely nothing ever. Well, nothing ever.
I bought you a burger back in the summertime.
Oh, yeah, from Burger King.
Yeah.
We talked about
that. Takeout window. Yeah.
Garbage.
Well, you were hungry.
Complete garbage.
You were hungry, and I just said, tell you what, Jay, I'm going to buy you a burger.
That's right. Yeah, so. Well, when you're starving, it doesn't matter the taste. You got to get something in your system. But if I have my choice, I can't believe that I worked all day for a Burger King hamburger, a Whopper Jr.
But did French fries came with that, too, and a drink?
Yeah, the French fries came maybe 10 minutes after the burger did because we're late on our fries. Go sit down. Yeah, what a joke.
Anyway, say it never gave you anything. Anyway, all right, I'll get you a lottery ticket, a Vegas ticket, a Vegas scratch ticket for Christmas.
That's all I'm asking. Can I not just, while I'm looking at my phone, you're complaining about that? That's what I'm doing.
I'm not complaining. I'm wondering if you're sitting there watching girls dancing TikTok or something on your phone.
I'm pulling up my next bit. I don't do it on paper, pop, water.
We're not ready for a bit. We got to talk about Herndon Estate Winery here now.
Yeah.
You know, you want to pick up some great winery products from Herndr's. Here's where you go now. 7 days a week for all your wine and Christmas needs until the big operation kicks in the springtime. That's 1179 4th Avenue inside Harvest Barn. Right inside Harvest Barn. Across from the St. Catherine's Hospital. It's all there.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful, Pat Porter.
So stop in. That's what you need, some good wine to get you going for Christmas.
Yeah, that's what
well.
I need. I was looking at Herndr's, and you know, a lot of their summer events have finished, but they have some stuff going on.
Yeah.
December 10th, they have some stuff going on.
And Christmas stuff,
and, yeah. I am Pat Porter. A little surprise for you.
Oh. Yeah, what's that?
InfamousJMoore.com is maybe 90% done. We were thinking about putting Herndr's up there as a sponsor, but I wasn't sure what we're going to be doing for the winter. But the Regency is up there on the InfamousJMoore.com page.
Already.
And also the links to 4680 if you want to get all the old archive podcasts. And I'm still working on it, Pop.
Okay, so it's not up entirely yet then.
Well, I'm tweaking a few things, but it's basically up.
So all you get now is a picture of your face.
And you get the bio of me and my history with you.
So what about me? Do I get spotted?
Yes, I was just going to say, we get the history of our wars together over the years and, yeah, and how we left terrestrial radio. It's all up there on InfamousJMoore.com.
All right.
So now, Pat Porter, when I have to say my socials and everything, you know how everybody does? Like, where can they get you reached at? And you got to say your Instagram, your Facebook.
Yeah.
All of my stuff, all of it.
Links to
everything is at InfamousJMoore.com, including the shows, Pat Porter, including the YouTube links, all the old promos we did from back in the day.
They're all up there?
They're all ready to go. Well, the links are, so okay. You can check out everything. Yeah. I have tons of footage on Pat Porter over the years. I have tons of old phone calls from the old radio station up there.
Oh, boy.
And I've loaded them all up, and it's locked and loaded on InfamousJMoore.com.
I gotta go home and check this out.
Yeah, well.
Okay, I'll see you later. I'm going now.
I've been nervous to tell you about this because I'm afraid you're going to sue me somehow.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, you're gonna sue me, of course.
No,
you're
no.
going to sue me for using your name.
Who would I talk to on my show if I didn't have you to kick around?
I don't know, but I know that the terrestrial radio, the corporate radio, as I like to call it, are all they want to do is contact a lawyer and sue somebody. So I know I'm getting sued, but I don't care. It's okay for the public.
I'll just haggle you and hassle you on the air.
But you know all these corporate sleaze bags. You know them all. They're all
I know how they work.
You
yeah.
know how they work.
Sure,
so
I worked in sales and radio sales and promotion and even a little bit in management, and I know what the deal is.
Yeah,
but now we got the best deal here. We can do what we want to do.
Absolutely.
And what people want to hear.
And it's great because the audience followed us over here because they miss it.
Isn't that funny?
We go to these live events and they love the old shows, you know, which are buried and gone, except for on my YouTube. I still own my own content, which is great. and it's all there, Pat Ward, is all I'm trying to say.
Well, you know, these shows that we do become podcasts, and you can get them right now at 4680Q.com
or
.ca.
That's right.
And you can listen to what we did a few weeks back or a month ago, or if you find something particularly thrilling, you can listen over and over.
Well, some people go back for some of the old guests that we have on. Yeah. Some people are fans, like Ken Patera, for example. Some people are old school wrestling fans. They want to buy the book, and then they hear the podcast, and they listen it over and over again. So they can hear what Ken has to say about, you know, especially with our style of questioning. Not that we ask much, but it's just different personalities mashed together that you never thought you'd hear together before, and we've done it.
Yeah.
Like Mysterion yesterday.
Yeah.
You know,
the great Mysterion.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. You know, if he had called any terrestrial radio station, they would say, well, we got to need to sponsor the event. It'd be a bunch of hassle. We put him on because we showcase good talent here in Niagara. And that's basically what the core of this show is all about. It's not about us. It's about what we showcase and what we allow, where terrestrial radio won't allow you.
No, you can't say anything.
You can't do that.
Keep
stuff.
Your mouth shut. You know, they pay you to talk, and then they say, keep your mouth shut. No, what good is that?
Infamous Jay Moore and Pat Porter have always been about supporting the community, supporting local, whether it's the independent music, whether it's wrestling, whether it's the boxing. Yeah. The events that we go to.
We actually go out and we meet the people. We say hello. We're real people.
That's right.
We get like tomorrow when we're going to be up in Hamilton. We're going to meet everybody.
We're going to meet everybody.
We don't hide behind a microphone and sneak out.
That's
right.
We have friends there. And we're not one of these people that, you know, set up a little tent and just give out stickers to the radio station.
Yeah, here, spin the wheel.
Some
win a sticker.
Kid, yeah. No, we do the actual meet and greet. And what's great is we don't charge money for this. We just give it to you. You want a selfie? I'll give you a selfie.
You got it.
Yeah.
It's not, we don't charge you $5 for a selfie.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah. Nothing. Exactly.
As long as you don't mind our stupid looking faces in your picture, we're happy to oblige.
Well, a lot of people just crop me right out of it, anyways.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Yeah. Smart people do it.
Right.
You know, they get back to the car and they get their picture out there and they start shrinking it down to get your face out of there.
Beautiful.
But they always leave my face in there.
They do. Everybody loves a great Pat Porter. I don't know what it is. I've been competing for years with you, and I always seem to lose out because everybody loves that hometown hero, Mr. Pat Porter.
Ah, there you go.
Yeah.
Yes. An extra 50 cents in your paycheck.
The voice of radio that they've been listening to in Niagara for decades, and and they love Pat Porter here in Southern Ontario.
We got one more sponsor we got to talk about.
Okay.
Crystal Ball Beach Cafe on Erie Road in Crystal Beach.
Yes.
And what a place.
I got word that you were perusing up there earlier this week, Pat.
I was down there. Yeah, Wednesday. I popped in. saw the manager, Robin Bannerman. Robin, of course, is running this cafe since, I think, about 5-6 years now or so, since the teens.
Mm-hmm.
This is the kind of place where you can just walk in, you can have yourself some breakfast or some lunch, and you can sit back. They've got entertainment at night. They've got artwork on the walls that they change every month. A different artist that puts something up, and you can buy these things.
Yeah.
And just sit back and relax and enjoy yourself. It's a great place to just hang out.
Yeah.
And good food. And I'll tell you, there was even a guy sitting down there on Wednesday. It was cold. He's sitting there in shorts and a t-shirt.
Oh, because there's still beachers out there. They still love it. They still love
their beaches. That's right. It's like they're all Jimmy Buffett style beach people.
And that's a secret about what's happening in Crystal Beach right now is people forget, once the beach season is over with, they just kind of forget about what's going on in Crystal Beach. But we're here to tell you that there's a ton to do down there.
Yeah.
That whole strip is, it's a poppin'.
Crystal Chandelier's down there.
Yeah, Crystal Chandelier. They got great food and the great drinks and great times and music and all kinds of things just because of the beach is kind of shut down for the season.
You can still access the beach and take a walk.
There you go. You can take a walk for Pat Porter,
Yeah, it's fun time. Fun place down there.
You know,
maybe not hard to get to.
Smoke a joint while you walk down there.
Did you say that on the radio?
No, I'm sorry, yeah.
I guess you can say that on the radio now. All right.
Shout outs to corporate management.
There you go, yeah. Crystal Ball Beach Cafe, Robin Bannerman and the crowd down there, and Julius Banfi hangs out down there all the
time. Yes, I know Julius.
He doesn't like me to say his name out loud because he's always in trouble.
Well, he doesn't mind walking to the radio station and burst in here and interrupt shows to say hi. So why can't we say your name?
That's right. Yeah.
Shout outs to you too.
Okay. So there we go. We got people covered.
Yeah.
And so what do you want to play, some more music, or you want to?
Let's do some music, Pat Porter. I think I need a break.
Or you want some? So you were asking me if I'd play some Helen Reddy, I Am Woman, or something like that. Is that what you wanted to hear?
I don't know what that is. I reserve those things for the hashtag Pat Porter show. You can take a deep dive into the music. I don't know.
I got your playlist here that you put together, so let's see what we got.
All right.
As soon as I can get it to kick in here.
Obviously it's a mystery.
No, it's just my finger's not working on this. Here we go. Oops. Here we go. It came up.
One thing about terrestrial radio is they had better equipment.
No, we got good equipment. It's just me doing it. That's the problem.
You can drop the needle, Pat Porter.
This is Wolf Mother, Joker and the Thief.
in the night.
Jay Moore Show.
Yeah, happy Saturday, Pat
Porter. Thank you, Jay. And Joker and the Thief Wolf Mother there.
I love it. Yeah, we're rocking it up here at 4680. Let me tell you something that I like, Pat Porter, something that is going on that I'm not liking. I'll give you two things here.
Okay, that you don't like.
I'm a huge fan, and I'm just going to admit things on air. I'm just going to come clean with everybody. Yeah. I'm a huge fan of the self-checkout that you get at stores.
Yeah.
And the reason I am is because... you could slip a few things in the bag without going through and paying for it.
No, I can't imagine you would do that.
No, if you get like a thing of a bacon, you could like double them up together, scan one.
By accident.
By accidentally on purpose, putting it in your bag. And it seems to be that they're catching on to that now.
You know, they got these gates when you walk out of the store. They're supposed to beep if you're trying to thieve something, you know. But do they beep or are they just there for looks?
Okay, I'll be fair here.
Yeah.
At No Frills, I get away with it. At Shoppers Drug Mart, I get away with it. At the other ones, I'm not too sure. Okay. I'm not too sure if they work or not.
But all this stuff that you put in your bag by accident, at some places you can actually get away with it by accident.
Yes, okay. Yes. Right. And if you act stupid about things, like, I didn't know, you know.
I don't know how to push this button.
I won't tell you which No Frills, but I think you know where I used to live. I was stealing from there all the time. And going through the scanner.
Shame on you. Shame.
Well, they got insurance and stuff for that. They're covered.
So now you're stealing from the insurance company, too.
But the problem is, Pat Porter, a lot of businesses are looking at taking the self-checkout out, taking them out of the stores.
Yeah.
Because a lot of this has been happening. And here's a quote from somebody from Business Insider magazine that says, theft is common at self-checkout lanes, perhaps pointing to another reason why Walmart and other realtors are moving to limit or oversee the option of taking them out altogether.
Wow. I know now when you shop at Walmart, you know, you wait in line to get to the self-checkout area. It used to be you just wait in line when you see a green light there. That, okay, you're ready.
Yeah.
Now they've got somebody standing there that points you to where you're supposed to go.
Oh, yeah.
And they kind of keep an eye on what you're doing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And then you go to the exit. There's somebody standing there. It used to be the Walmart greeter.
Yeah.
Now they're the Walmart theft checker.
Yeah. So this is a joke about it because a lot of people were complaining when these first came in that it was going to put everybody out of work. It didn't put anybody out of work.
It put a lot of the staff at the cashiers out of work.
Well, maybe the staff and the cashiers, but one of the benefits of self-checkout, whether you like it or not, what I like about it is I don't have to stand in line and wait for some 16-year-old punk, you know, just throw the stuff in the bag, but they're yipping and yapping, like you say, to all the old ladies and everybody about what's going on, and Christmas is coming up, and my cousin is doing this, and Shirley down at the school has got a basketball game, and I'm just hearing all this rap while I'm in a long line where I could just scan the stuff and get out of there.
Yeah. Well, when it first came out, I thought, I have to work for the company. I have to do the work that they used to do.
Yeah.
I didn't like it.
Yeah.
But then the more I tried it, I thought, well, this is simple. You walk over there, you beep, 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 you put it in your bag, off you go.
Yeah.
You don't have to make small talk. You don't
have to wait
in line behind 15 people that can't find their card and forgot their PIN number.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could just self-check out and get out. So it's disappointing to me that that's going away, especially...
I don't think it's
going to
go away.
Well... I don't know how I'm going to get through Christmas without stealing. So I hope that they stay at least.
What are you
going to
buy
season?
For your girlfriend for Christmas? What can you steal for your girlfriend?
Something that goes through that scanner that I can get away with. Evidently, she wants a 70-inch TV.
Yeah, I'll try that.
Yeah, I'm not going to be able to get away with that. But I probably have
70-inch TV.
A 70-inch TV.
Is she blind?
Well, I don't know. The wall in my house is only 50 inches, so I don't know where the rest of it's going.
Yeah. Well,
I don't know. I just say please to Walmart and all these big realtors, please leave the self-checkout because just because I steal a few things, it's not a big deal. It's not a big
just
deal.
Just hang your picture by the door so when they see you coming, they'll know, you know,
whatever.
Watch out for this guy.
The only thing I don't steal is gas, but I bet you I can get away with that too. Because let's face it, you see these news reports of people with theft and everything. Somebody came to your house. These guys put a balaclava on and a hoodie on, and you don't know who it is. It's black and white, and they're gone.
So you shop with a balaclava and a hoodie on?
Well, in the days of COVID, you can get away with that.
That's right. Everybody's got a mask on.
It was the greatest thing ever, And you can still get away with wearing a mask today because people think that you're doing the right thing. You're protecting everyone from sickness.
Wow.
I don't know. Maybe this online radio is a bad idea where you can just say what you want because I'm probably going to get roasted.
Well,
for
there's
a lot
cops
of-
waiting right outside
okay.
there. See, they just pulled up
Here
front.
There you go.
Yeah, cop cars. They heard
Shout
you on the radio.
Shout out to No Frills. Thank you for the free meals over the years, but it was it was fun.
You know what else?
I'll
go to the takeout window. This is another thing. Excuse me. I got this frog living
in
my throat here.
I'm going to take a drink. What do you got to do?
I got no drink. I drank it. I drank my drink. Is that right? I drank it. I drank my drink, and now I'm drunk.
I'd offer you water, but the fridge is probably empty here at the station.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll go takeout window. These are another big thing that I can't stand. You give your order to the squawk box, right? I speak clearly. I'm a radio announcer. I can speak very plainly and clearly. You know.
I know what you're going to say. Go ahead.
Yeah, I give the order. You know, I want this on my burger. I don't want this on it. I don't want French fries. No, I don't need any ketchup. You know, whatever.
Yeah.
They pull up, pull up to the window. You pay the guy in the first window. Then you move on to the second window. And then zip the window open. Somebody takes a bag and heaves it at you. There's your lunch.
Get out of here.
Yeah. And you can't stop and examine everything because you got five cars behind you.
Yeah.
So you pull away and
That's
everything's
right.
wrong.
Everything's absolutely wrong. You're 100% about that. And I get that a ton of times from a lot of places where it's just, I don't know. I'm sorry. I'm going to put this out there. I know we don't say these things anymore, but it's millennials. Hey, the millennials get it all wrong. They don't listen. They don't care. And,
why don't they pay attention?
I don't know. Like you said, you got a trained radio voice, and you're talking to the squawk box, and they just and you speak very clearly.
And I stop. I don't just say, oh, hamburger and a French fry, and I'll have this and I'll have that. I itemize each item.
Yeah.
And I give them time to mark it down or whatever they have to do.
That's right.
But they don't care.
They don't care. This is another thing that's got to stop before we go any further. This paying it forward at the drive-thru. It's ridiculous. I know it's a nice gesture. I know people want to pay for other people's food, but this is what's making the kitchen so confusing and these people cashing out so confused is now this guy's paying for your food. I don't know what's going on. did this the other day.
All you know right. What did you steal?
Well, you have the double
two
lanes,
yeah.
The two lanes, yeah. So you go into the one lane, and at this particular fast food establishment, I got yelled at for cutting a guy off, which I did not. I placed
it was your turn. You pulled forward.
It was my turn, and this guy's yelling about, hey, you're not supposed to go. I'm not supposed to go. So I did the I'll pay it forward stuff.
Yeah.
And I took his food and left. I said, I'm just paying for my buddy back there. He doesn't have enough money. And then I took his food and then I left.
So when he pulled up, there was nothing there for him.
I don't
him.
Care. I wish it was a good order because I would have ate it, but I ended up just throwing it out.
Out the window.
I could have just gave it to the homeless in Tent City, I guess, but I don't know.
Well, you think anybody, you pull up to the Tent City where the homeless are sitting around. You come up with a bag of food from the takeout window. You think they're going to take that from you and eat it? I doubt it. Yeah.
You don't even think the homeless will eat my fast
they
food.
They want cash. They don't want you to e-transfer money to their account because they don't have any account. Yeah. Or, you know, they're waiting there on the corner. You know, they stand in front of the building and they got their guitar case out.
Yeah.
And they're looking at you with, pleading eyes, to throw something in the guitar.
Right.
Well, I just say, I don't have any cash. I have you got credit? You got MasterCard? they give me a look. I shouldn't tell these stories that make me look like an evil person.
Well, no, we're going to hell today, Pat Porter.
Yeah,
I think we've uncovered a lot about ourselves, and we're just being real with the audience. If you don't like it, hey, man, throw me off the air. That's all I got to say.
Jay steals the stuff. I'm just rude. there's the difference.
There's the difference, and I think that's the chemistry that brought us together, and even though... we annoy each other. We bug each other, the audience.
I'm used to you by now.
Yeah, I know.
I'm used to your annoyances and your the way you treat me, I mean, with disrespect most of the time.
I'm just trying to get the job done, Pat Porter. I'm trying to put out radio there. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. I don't know.
I think we'll get you back to 90 seconds like you used to be allowed at the other station, and then I'd hang up on you.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, people like that.
Yeah, you're just the bitter old guy that doesn't want to hear from the youngsters. And
I think you were a youngster like years ago. I think you passed that marker.
Yeah, I really am. Yeah. I'm becoming old in my thinking too, and I'm bitter and I don't like anything.
There you go. Crotchety old Jay Moore now, the infamous crotchety old man.
And you know what? I really don't mind it. I like being in this condition, to be honest with you. It doesn't bother me, yes.
So now your girlfriend's probably listening right now, and she's going to expect that you're going to show up at Christmas with a 70-inch television set.
I just need
somebody.
Can't
even get that through the door.
Yeah, I can't do anything with a 70-inch TV. And on one hand, I could tell her no, but that's living in hell, too, if you tell her no.
Well, look, Santa will bring it,
Well, that's a good one, yeah.
Yeah, go sit on Santa's lap.
Yeah.
Santa like that.
Maybe she'll buy into the imaginary fiction and character. Then maybe she'll buy into that at her age. I don't know. I don't know what to do, Pat Porter, but...
are you looking forward to Christmas?
No, I never do.
No, never?
No, I never do.
Well, what's the worst part for you at Christmas time?
I think my bank account, it just goes for a bust. Yeah, I think my bank account, buying stuff for, no offense to people that I buy stuff for, but they know who they are, the people that I don't even like or care about. You know what I mean? People, there's just stuff out there, like people that you work with. Yeah. I'm not going to say family.
Secret Santa stuff, eh?
Yeah, I mean, this is all a joke.
You pull somebody's name out of a hat and you got to buy them a present.
I think once you're past the age of 12, who cares about Christmas? I guess...
Tis the season to be jolly.
Deep down, it's about, Jesus Christ dying on the cross.
Well, it's a religious component to it,
Deep down, but we don't really think about that. We have, Winter Festival of Lights, we have celebrations.
Santa Claus, you got the Easter Bunny,
parades going around, I don't know. I'm just not a fan of it. It's just too much.
I don't like to make the rounds of all the relatives. Because you never see these people until Christmas shows up. And then all of a sudden, everybody wants you to come and visit.
Yeah.
And you sit there and you visit with all these old relatives that you don't have anything in common with.
Well, I knew you were going to say that. I knew you were going to say that. And I was going to say that, but I knew you would say that. So I was
How'd you know that? How'd you know? You know my relatives?
Well, no. It's just I think there's a lot of people out there that agree with you, Pat Porter, that don't want to see the relatives, that they would just rather stay home.
I don't want to see them.
No.
Send me a postcard, you know.
Oh, they all just talk about Coronation Street or whatever else they're watching on TV.
They all talk about other relatives that I don't know or never met.
Yeah.
They'll talk about the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren they have that I've never met.
There's
to me, all the babies look alike anyway. So, cute baby. That's great. Okay, flip the page. You know, what else you got?
Well, that's what my dad says, that they all look the same.
Yeah, they all look bald-headed little babies.
And there's all kids in my family that I don't even know or have met and will never meet. Believe it or not,
no.
There's a ton of people in my family that I'll never meet. You know, maybe I'm being irresponsible, but there's people in my family that I don't even know that I don't even know their names.
Yeah.
Is that bad?
No, I don't know who they are in my family either. They show up all the time at a special holiday, and I'm supposed to be there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and act nice.
And what's worse about that is when you do have a job in radio, all they want to know is about what you do in radio.
They don't have a clue.
They don't have a clue, and they just, it's just...
If you start telling them what you actually do and the appearances that we make and the things that we you know, contend with, they go, that's nice. Let me tell you about my grandchild.
That's right. Yeah. Well, speaking of that, too, like the worst that's for me is you go to these family functions and they say, well, you never come over, you never visit and everything.
Because I don't like you.
Well, there's that I don't like you. But I always go with, like, we're always doing these shows on the weekend and nobody understands the agenda that we have when we're doing these weekend shows and you're working through the week. You don't have a day off to go sit around and have crackers with somebody in your family to
drink
talk about.
Tea.
Yeah. Yeah. About issues that are never going to get resolved anyways. No. Or, you know what I mean? It's just, it's a joke.
I always plan an escape route.
Yeah, you know, shout-outs to the Neufelds. I love them. And shout-outs to the Moore family. And shout-outs to the Riegler family. I love those families. Anybody else that's extra? Not so much.
Yeah, I'm kind of lucky because most of my relatives are far, far, far away.
Yeah, so you could just stay home and watch TV.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's perfect. That's all I wanted to do.
Phone call, 5 minutes. Hey, how you doing? Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah, that's right.
That's it. See you next year.
That's right. Yeah.
Do we have time for any more music? We're running out of time here.
What do you want to do here, Pat Porter?
Do you want to play one more song?
One more, and let's sign off.
Then we'll
off
come back and say goodnight, and we'll sing a Christmas song to the people.
All right. Sounds good,
Pat. Okay?
Let's do it.
Find a great song here. All right, here's one from The Doors. You want to hear The Doors?
I would love to.
You were talking about Ray Manzarek instead of Ray Materek. And here's The Doors. And 5-1, 4680Q.
Love my girl. She looking good. Come on. One more. 5-1, baby. Make it, baby, in our prime. together one more time.
Get together one more time.
Get together one more time.
Get together.
There you go, The Doors, in for Miss J. Moore show, just about ready to pack it in for the day. We're going to have to go back to the original Rick Rose playlist and get that on the air.
That's it for me. I got nothing, Pat Porter. I'm going to see Bush tonight. We'll be at Leander Boat Club tomorrow for Sonny DeRio's birthday. You can join us there.
In case no one's ever heard, in case they haven't caught on, Sonny's having a birthday party tomorrow.
That's right. We've only been stomping it into the ground about 800 times on the shows.
And we're not the only ones either.
No, it's going to be a great party tomorrow in Hamilton. So join us. Join us because you're welcome there. And it's going to be a great time, and we would love to see you down at Sonny Del Rio's big birthday. Blues music all afternoon long, all night long. It starts at 7, like you said, Pat Porter.
Yeah.
And that's going to be great. InfamousJMoore.com, where you can get all the shows and all the details and all the information about Infamous J. Moore Show with Pat Porter, as well as Hitting the 12 and all the news. And, of course, Pat Porter back next Friday at 3. And we're back together next Saturday at 3 o'clock here on 4680Q, Infamous J. Moore Show with Pat Porter.
Got it. Catch you then. Have a nice weekend, what's left of it, and we'll catch you next weekend.